Hello everyone, welcome to Locasing Academy. This is Jaskiran. So in this video, we are going to cover our next topic, that is how you can store Google Form responses in a spreadsheet. So as on the screen, you can see that I have created this demo test in the first video in which I have explained how you can add all the types of questions. So you can see that I have added short type of answer, paragraph, multiple and checkbox list and drop-down list. So I have tried to add each and every type of question here. So once you have created this form or your Google Form, in Google Form you don't need to do anything extra to store respondents' answers, because by default it will save each and every answer in the responses tab. So here you can see the responses tab, just click on that. Currently, I have zero responses because I haven't sent this Google Form to anyone. So let's add some responses. And this is a live form with the results from each respondent. So here you can see there are three tab for summary, for question and for individual. So this live form is great for quick form results. And here you can see that in the summary we have a list of all the respondents that have entered their name and their question types. You can also see the graphs that how many respondent selected which kind of option in the multiple type of question, and which color is the favorite one in the majority of people, and where do you live. So it's pretty simple if you see this summary in the live form view. But for more tools to analyze answer, you can link this Google Form to your Google Sheet spreadsheet anytime. So just come here at the top of the screen and just click on this create spreadsheet button here. So when you click on this spreadsheet button, it will open up this window where you see that create a new spreadsheet, and you have another option that select existing spreadsheet. And guys, you can store results from multiple forms in one spreadsheet, and each form responses will be saved to a separate sheet. But you cannot, however, save multiple forms responses to a single sheet. So I'm just creating a totally different spreadsheet for this forms itself. So just click on this create button. So this our Google Sheet spreadsheet will open up, and you can see all the question types here with in the form of a spreadsheet. So here you can see all the questions and their respondent answers with them. So here you can easily manage a Google Sheet, just filter out, just apply a filter anywhere you like. For example, you want to apply a filter on here, on this column here. So you want to filter about only see the people who lives in Panchkula, for example. So just click on this button here. Okay, so that will show all the people that are live in Panchkula. So only 3% that lives in Panchkula. So you can do all sort of things and apply formulas and other things to this spreadsheet. So one great thing about saving Google Forms entry to Google Sheet spreadsheet, because it's fast and you can change your form fields name and they are automatically updated into your spreadsheet, and you get a new entry and it will show up in the spreadsheet as soon as your recipient clicks submit button. And one thing you should note about this spreadsheet, that you can change form questions and answer options at any time, but if you do, it won't change the entries that have already been added to your spreadsheet. And Google Forms always keep a full copy of all your form data, so if you accidentally delete something from your spreadsheet, don't worry, just open up your form response settings and unlink it from your spreadsheet, or click form and unlink form inside your spreadsheet. So let's see how you can do this. Just open up your form here and click on this three dotted button. So when you click on this three dotted button, it will open up these settings. Just to click on this unlink form, so it will unlink this spreadsheet from your form. So I'm unlinking from this form, and just click on this unlink form button here. So are you sure that you want to unlink this form with the current spreadsheet? So just click on unlink. So it will unlink your form from the spreadsheet, and now you have to again click on this create spreadsheet button and just click on create button. So it will create a new spreadsheet with the all the answers that you have mistakenly deleted something from the spreadsheet. So with your form data in the spreadsheet, you can use Google Sheets formula, as I stated earlier in this video, and you can calculate values and make custom graphs to visualize your data, and you can do conditional formatting to the spreadsheet, and you will be able to see the patterns in your form responses at a very good glance. There's one other handy extra with Sheets notification that in Google Forms by default can email you whenever the form is filled. So for that, you have to again come to this form settings and just click on three dotted button, and you can check this options here, get email notification for new responses. So I'm just checking that. So whenever a new respondent filled out this form, I will get a email notification for that. There are also some other options like print all responses or download responses in CSV file. So I'm just printing all responses, just click on this button, and it will start loading up the print layout, and you could also see the preview of all the questions that are filled up by the respondents. So here in the print preview, you can see all the respondents' name and their options that they have selected in this Google form. So that is one and that is second. So depending upon how many respondents have submitted this form, and you can also delete all the responses if you want. Just click on the delete all responses, and you can also change the response destination where you are saving this spreadsheet. Just click on that, and it will ask you to create a new spreadsheet for this existing form, or you can select a existing spreadsheet. So it's all depend upon your requirement. So guys, that is all about storing your form responses in a spreadsheet, and how to view live form in responses tab. In the next video, we will be looking at how to collaborate your forms and how to set privacy settings in Google Forms. Thanks for watching this video, and if you like my videos, please subscribe my channel. Thanks a lot.